you, sir. Distinguished Secretary Textile, sir, and friends, good afternoon. I'm here on behalf of the Indian Technical Textile Association, which is a body that has about 400 members in India doing different kinds of activities in the field of technical textiles. Normally, when I'm asked to talk about technical textiles, I start with a broad definition saying that it's a very different industry from the segments of industry of textiles as we know it, like spinning, and garments, or processing, and etc. Because if about 15 of us sit in the boardroom of ITA, we have quickly come to realize that none of us have got anything to do with each other's businesses. We are all operating in completely different segments. So to put it all into one basket and to represent is sometimes a little difficult and challenging, but then that's where we are. There might be absolutely no relevance with the challenges that the geotextile manufacturer faces to what a pro-tech manufacturer faces for uniforms or somebody who does sanitary products like diapers or napkins does. But then I'm just going to give you an overview that sort of fits all this together. The Indian technical textile industry story has been one of largely individual enterprise and leadership. Without, I should say, unfortunately, any sustainable competitive advantage that the ecosystem provides to us. I mean that in the sense of if you have, let's take the obvious example of cotton spinning, the largest cotton producer in the world, you've got the best machinery set up for production in the world, world class, nothing to beat. You have a trained workforce, like one of the earlier speakers was saying, Southeast Asia, you see everybody who is operating in the spinning industry outside India, it's usually in India. So that's an ecosystem that gives you a competitive edge which other people cannot beat. Unfortunately, the technical textile sector predominantly operates in an environment that doesn't have any of these. We don't have, barring maybe one or two manufacturers, but they're not really world class, we don't have a machinery manufacturing set up in this country for making technical textiles. In almost no segment. Every single one of the plants that is operated by large manufacturers, and I'm sure Mr. Lalbhai would bear with me on this, the technology comes from overseas. So there is no inherent country advantage in terms of technology sourcing. And then, as a corollary, the amount of skilled manpower at a higher level to operate this is also this big positive for them. There is no inherent raw material advantage you have here. The chemicals that we coat in more advanced formats comes from overseas. Raw materials, yes, it's predominantly synthetic. Base polyesters, no issues. But if you get into any high density material, if you get into aramids, if you get into nylon 66, doesn't exist inside this country. There's no indigenous technology that has been commercialized on any scale that we can talk about. So what is really driving this industry at this point of time is purely individual enterprise. The members who go out there and find a niche that they're able to actually capitalize upon, and then at various levels of success, they're able to run this industry right now. What we have that can be a game changer is access to one of the largest consumer markets that's available over here in the country. The per capita consumption is possibly the lowest. It will be like, you know, if you see the numbers, it will be shocking. They are very shocking. There are Southeast Asian countries that, smaller countries that who you would not think are on that scale, who consume much more than us in terms of technical textiles as such. It's not a question of import substitution alone. That's one component of it. The overall consumption within this country is very low. And that's been the largest challenge that we have, that we do not have this whole ecosystem, and that ecosystem will only come if the market demand actually comes inside. And that's why, while there have been pockets of excellence, broadly, it's been a slow story, a story in the making. I'm an eternal optimist, but I can say that I'm extraordinarily optimistic in the last 3 months. It's not just because the secretary is at this table, but I have wanted to recognize this in a broader industry forum. The work that's happening in the textile ministry is unprecedented in spearheading the cause of technical textiles in this country with a mandate from the PMO and, as sir said, with the aegis of the principal scientific advisor and co-chaired by sir himself. There's an unprecedented amount of push to mandate and enforce the use of technical textiles across the various ministries of the Indian government. And that singularly is going to change the face of the technical textile industry in India in the months to come, let me not say years to come, in the months to come. I think good times are all for us. It is my duty to place a record when something unprecedented like this is happening. Sir, thank you so much for doing it. That's where we are. That's a great future. That's a great future because we have the brains. And if there's one message I want to leave, and it's a very short time, is there are emerging opportunities where we can leapfrog those technology hurdles that we are facing. The world is going eco. There are products that are going eco. Like this flex banner is not going to exist anymore in the country after 1 year's time. It's going to be a cotton banner with the same kind of print quality, same kind of thing with a complete biodegradability. The ministry is thinking of jute, bagasse, sugarcane bagasse as components of fill for the sanitary napkins, because there's going to be a huge problem in terms of all your diapers and all your hygiene products that are going into landfill masses and cannot be recycled. Those are areas which other countries are not thinking about right now, but in India those things are happening. You might, with the right kind of industry, I mean R&D associations, and with the right kind of ecosystem which is available in the country, it's just a little nascent and needs a little bit of push, you might be able to be thought leaders, technology leaders in renewable technical textiles. That might not cover the entire gamut, but there's enough of an area of growth there that can make this an India success story. And with that, thank you all the organizers for giving me this opportunity, and thank you so much.